Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. In today's video, we're kicking off a new series where we dive deep into how the Linux operating system works. This is part one, and we are going to break down the key components of Linux from booting up to logging into your desktop screen. So if you're ready to learn the fundamentals, let's get started. So, Linux. Linux, as you know, is an open source operating system. And for booting the Linux operating system, we need something called as the bootloader. So what is the bootloader? A bootloader is a small program that loads your operating system. So the most common bootloader for Linux is the GRUB bootloader, which is this. And we also have an alternative, which is called as the systemd boot. Both of these let you choose which operating system to boot if you have multiple operating systems, as well as the versions. So Linux has different kernel versions. So as you update your operating system, each kernel version will be there in the GRUB bootloader. What does booting do? Booting loads the Linux kernel into the memory. Now once the GRUB loads, the next step is the kernel. And what is a kernel? The kernel is the heart of the operating system. It's responsible for managing hardware, memory, processes, and everything that makes the computer work. It acts as a bridge between the hardware and the rest of the system. Now, without the kernel, nothing would run. Once the kernel has taken over the control, you interact with the Linux through the shell. Now, the shell is a command line interface that lets you issue commands to the system. Now, one common terminal you use in the TTY or the teletype terminal by default is the 6 provided TTYs, and it is accessed through pressing Ctrl Alt and then the function with the number. Now let's say we have to open the TTY 1. Now for TTY 1, we need to press Ctrl Alt and the function F1 key. So by default, we have total of 6 TTYs. While the operating system boots, the default TTY which will open will be the TTY 1 if you have no graphical user interface. Each TTY gives you a separate command line session. This is useful for multitasking or if you are running multiple tasks without a graphical user interface. Until now, we were just talking about the command line interface. Now comes the picture of graphical user interface. For having a graphical user interface, we need two packages. First one is the display manager. And then we have other one which is called as the display server. Now the display manager is also called as DM. The DM is responsible for managing user sessions and logging you into the desktop environment or the window manager. Once you log in, your system needs a display server to handle the graphics. The two most common display servers are the X server and the Wayland server. X server has been around for decades, while Wayland is a newer, modern alternative design to be efficient and more secure. Now that we have a display server, it's time for the desktop environment. A DE gives you the graphical interface. It includes things like icons, menus, and window management. Some of the few popular examples are GNOME, KDE, XFCE, and there are so many others. Underneath the DE, there is a window manager that controls how windows behave. Some desktop environments come with their own window management, but you can also use a lightweight window manager which prevents you from using the desktop environment. Desktop environment is more of a user-friendly interface so that people who shift from Windows to Linux can learn and then understand how it works. And then if your productivity is lower, you can come to window managers. A window manager is just plain window management, wherein you have lightweight options such as i3, Awesome Window Manager, then you have Hyperland, in which you have the complete control and efficiency. Now to recap, Linux uses bootloader such as GRUB and then loads the kernel. Once the kernel is loaded, shell is the one which interacts with the kernel and sends all the command signals, whatever you input. Next, after the shell, you have something called as the TTY. TTY acts as the virtual console and it can be accessed through the Control Alt function keys. Next, you have something called as the display manager. Now, display manager is responsible for the login screen where users can login using their account. Next, display server is the one which is responsible for displaying the desktop environment or the window manager. A desktop environment also consists of window manager, but it is more user friendly, whereas window manager is lightweight and you need to configure it in such a way that you can use it with extreme productivity. I know it's a lot to take in, but understanding these components will help you get the most out of the Linux system. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and drop any questions you have in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.